Now the thing is that the antenna coupler in the right corner, you have been seen that you have seen that there is a practical internal configuration of antenna coupler, and that is the in the left corner you can left leaning corner you have seen that that is the practical antenna coupler. What does it do? It performs no amplification and has no active devices, but it performs two important jobs, that's impedance matching and filtering. The antenna coupler also acts the low pass filter that is important to transmit through antenna. Now the discussion comes to again the high level amplitude modulation transmitters. There are the RF carrier oscillator, buffer amplifier, then RF power amplifier, then RF final PA and modulator. Okay, and there is a mic, there is a AF voltage amplifier, there is a AF power amplifier. So there is difference between these two things. In previous low level amplifier, there you can see that in low level part, that is there is no such kind of power amplifier has been used. But here the two power amplifiers, that is RF power amplifier, that is AF power amplifier, that has been used. So that is the difference between these two things. Otherwise all the things are quite same. And so the summary of low level and high level characteristics are that the low level transmitters can produce any kind of modulation, AM, FM, PM or PM, okay. The negative thing is that they require linear RF power amplifiers, which reduces DC efficiency and increases production costs. The thing is that they require the RF power amplifiers to reduce the DC efficiency, and that increases the production cost. But in high level transmitter have better DC efficiency than low level transmitters and are very well suited for battery operation. Okay, for battery operation we have to use the high level transmitters. Okay, and the negative part is that for high level transmitter that they are restricted to generating AM modulation only. So they are restricted to generating just AM modulation. They are not gonna use in the FM or PM transmitters. So now the DSB-SC modulator comes to action. What are the DSB-SC modulators? The description of modulators. Here is a certain kind of modulator, AM modulator, the local oscillator. There are two AM modulators are there. The first is positive modulation, second is negative modulation. Why that is positive and negative, that has been put over here. That doesn't mean that is the negative, or that doesn't mean that is a positive. The thing is that in DSB-SC modulator, the lower side, there are two side bands. In frequency spectra, in frequency, that is bandwidth versus amplitude graph, we have seen the lower side band one line, upper side band one line. But if we make the one line to a certain bandwidth, that are known as the side bands. There are two side bands, upper side band and the lower side band. So that is the basic block diagram where carrier signal is on the middle of the part, that is generated by the local oscillator, and two modulators are situated there, and two signals has been make summation and get these things in the DSB-SC modulator. That is a double sideband single carrier modulator. That is a single carrier that you have seen here. A double sideband single carrier modulation. So there is, in the position of the carrier is a single line. But the lower sideband, upper sideband carrier is suppressed and sidebands are allowed for transmission. So in that kind of thing, this carrier is suppressed. So that is denoted as the dotted line, and the lower sideband and the upper sideband that is allowed to transmission. There is that is the CT, that is the carrier signal, that is the MT, that is the modulated signal. Both are modulated to each other with the multiplication. then you can get PT, PUSB plus PLSB. That means upper sideband and lower sideband powers has been added, and that can be the total power. Here, no carrier power is used. That is the main thing in DSB-SC modulator. Double sideband, some of the suppressed carrier is known as suppressed carrier. Double sideband suppressed carrier modulation, suppressed carrier, and there is used just a single carrier, and that has been suppressed, and that is a single sideband suppressed carrier. Again, the carrier has been suppressed, but the SSP AC system modulator that provides a 90 degree phase shifter to avoid another sideband, and the carrier sideband, carrier and the sideband are suppressed, and a single sideband is allowed for transmission. That can be lower sideband or that can be upper sideband can used for transmission. If it is upper sideband, so that is the SSB SCU, that means upper sideband. If it is SSB SCL, that is lower sideband, so the thing will be that will be in the transmission side, and that will be shown as the dotted side. That means that's not the active region, and that is the active region. So that is the SSBSC system, and the position of the carrier always been suppressed as previous. So there is a product modulator, there is a carrier modulator here, two carrier modulator, and this carrier modulator after 90 degree phase shifter, the cos will be shifted as sine. Again, go to the product modulator, and that is the AM cos twice by FM. Again, 90 degree phase shifter, make it to the sine. These two sinusoidal value go through to the product modulator, and a local oscillator is here, and both things, the S1 and S2 has been summation, and get the total modulated voltage. The advantages of this kind of SSPSC modulator, you have to keep on your mind that is not the single carrier, okay? Apologies to that. That is suppressed carrier. That is suppressed carrier. SSB SC, single sideband suppressed carrier. DSB SC, double sideband suppressed carrier. That means these carriers are not been used to or allowed to for transmission. So the advantages of this thing is bandwidth or spectrum space occupied is lesser than amplitude modulation and DSB-SC waves. Transmission of more number of signals is allowed. Power is saved. High power signal can be transmitted. Less amount of noise is present. Signal fading is less likely to occur. Now, the vestigial sideband suppressed carrier, that is DSB-SC modulation, is the process where a part of signal called a vestige is modulated along the one sideband. What is the vestige side? Okay, and what is vestigial sideband? That is a part of a signal that is vestige. Okay, what is vestige? That means that has been guarded through certain kind of barriers or guard bands. Okay. Here you can see there is a tilt way of this signal, the part of LSB, and there is part of the USB, and both carriers are situated in a certain kind of carrier suppressed by this USB and LSB. There are some bends there. So these things are the vestige part. There should have to be like that, but these parts has been rejected. And that is a sharp bend on that, and that is the lower part of it. So these kind of signals can be generated like that.